This is Kim Hammer with your devotion taken from 1 Samuel chapter 29, begin with verse 1. The Philistine army was assembling to go and attack the nation of Israel. And as a result, the Philistine king asked David if he would be his bodyguard. In those days, the king would travel at the rear of the army in order to protect him and put a layer between him and the army that they were attacking. The commanders of the Philistine army did not like that at all. And after much argument, they persuaded the king that David did not need to be his bodyguard, nor did he need to go with them into battle along with his army, because they said in the heat of the battle, David will try to win favor with Saul and would kill the king and as many as he could in order to gain favor back with Saul. In fact, the Philistine commanders reminded the king of what had been said years before, and that is that Saul had killed his thousands, but David had killed his tens of thousands. And after much persuasion, the king said, all right, and he told David that he could not go with him, which upset David because David was a loyal individual. He said, I've been with you over a year and this is the way that you're going to treat me. But at the end, the king of the Philistines said, it's what the commanders want. You need to go back to your city. Now, as you read the scriptures, you find that it was a 3-day journey for David to get back to the city that he had left. So that means it was a 3-day city. It was a 3-day journey away from his city. For 6 days, he had been gone. During that time, the Amalekites had come and attacked the city that David and all of his army was from. And they took the family members of David and all of the army that was with him, and they also plundered not only that city, but another city. When David arrived at the city and found that it was being burned, it says that he and his men wept bitterly until they had no strength. And then it says that David also grieved because the men talked about stoning him because he had led them away from the city unprotected. And also it said that they had an evil spirit toward David. But yet David showed his real spiritual strength in that he said in chapter 30 and verse 6, David found strength in the Lord his God. And as a result of that, he called the priest who brought the ephod and he consulted of the Lord to say, should I pursue them and will I overtake them? And God answered him and said, yes, pursue them and you will overtake them. As a result, David overtook that army and not only did he defeat them, he retrieved all of his family, all the plunder from the city that they had taken, but also the other city that they had taken plunder from, so much so that David was able to divide it among all the families, and he sent portions out to the other. At that moment that the king of the Philistines was telling David that he had to go and David was so upset, little did he realize that that was actually God protecting him and protecting his family, because had he waited any longer, he might not have retrieved them. In the moment, David thought that he was being punished for his loyalty, when in reality, God was protecting him. Sometimes in the midst of things that we may not agree with or that we may become upset about, maybe we need to give time to work, for God to work, to realize that maybe he is just protecting us or protecting those around us when we don't even realize it at the time.